This video is dedicated to Martha Ray, a true friend to the Army of Vietnam.
Welcome home. War is hell, buddy. Welcome home.
That's Tyler. He's almost 17 now. He's your boy, Jake.
Can I talk to you?
All I want is for you to go back to wherever you came from and leave us alone.
I'll do that. If that's what you want.
That's all I want.
Can I just talk to you first? 5 minutes? I made a mistake coming here. I know that. I didn't mean for this to happen. When I found out about you, all those years I never knew about you.
And what about Mom? You knew about her, right?
Tyler, you don't understand. There's no way.
Are you a deserter?
What?
I asked somebody what would happen if a guy who was to be dead showed up from Vietnam after 17 years. He said that guy would either be a hero or a deserter. If you're a hero, I guess I'd have seen you on TV, right?
I'm not a deserter. I'm no hero either. Tyler, look at me. There are things I can't talk about now.
Fine. So just leave then, okay? If you're feeling sorry for me, don't. I've got a father. The only one I want.
I'm not trying to take Woody's place.
You couldn't. All you could do is hurt him and Mom.
Tyler.
You know what this is? Woody took me to the Vets Memorial in Washington so I could find your name there. Well, that's it. Right up there with 50,000 other dead guys. Now, would you just get out of here?
I'm sorry.
I don't know what you hope to accomplish with this political grandstanding, Camden. Except another term in office, if you manage to pull it off. I also don't know what you want from me.
I have managed to arrange a diplomatic passport for Lieutenant Robbins. We assume you have the paperwork necessary to allow his children to leave Thailand and enter the United States. That is what we want from you, Colonel Barnes.
You realize if you go through with this, you may be returning to face charges of desertion.
Colonel, let's say that in 1973, a body is misidentified. It's happened before. And Lieutenant Robbins here is listed as killed in action. 6 years later, Defense Intelligence investigates a reported sighting, backed up by a full set of fingerprints, and determines that the lieutenant is indeed alive. Now, this could get a little embarrassing. But you can't get to him without risking an international incident, and he can't get out. So all you've got to do to cover your ass is bury the evidence, do nothing, and hope he stays put. But 8 years later, Jake suddenly pops up. And now we've got a major fuck-up that started 14 years ago and has been compounded by cover-ups all the way down the line.
I think I should remind you that an inquiry on charges of collaboration is still pending. What you do at this point could greatly influence any decisions in that matter.
Colonel, I don't care what your people try to do to me. I told you all I wanted was my family back, but I was wrong. I want something more. I want me back. And I want whoever that man is who's buried next to my mother back with his family. They deserve to know he's been accounted for, not just missing in some goddamn bureaucratic limbo.
Colonel, my committee has no way of knowing that Lieutenant Robbins is an isolated case. That there may not be others whose whereabouts have been likewise known, but not acknowledged. We're not going to let go of this.
You are making a very big mistake, Senator. This could reach a hell of a lot further than you realize. What you're doing could cause a great deal of embarrassment.
It would all be a great deal less embarrassing if it involved only an old cover-up occurring during a previous administration. Wouldn't you agree, Colonel? Unless necessitated by your lack of cooperation, or by his defense in a court-martial proceeding, I see no reason that Lieutenant Robbins would feel compelled to pursue allegations of the more recent attempts to suppress this evidence.
A magnificent experience of human emotion.
My brother was in Vietnam. He was in the motor pool. He made it back home to us alive. The war was in our living rooms every day and every night on the news, so it touched all of us. I was just able to visit the wall last year when our nephew invited us to come visit him in D.C. It was a drizzly, overcast, rainy day, but there were people there wiping the rain off of the names of their friends. When you approach the wall, you're speechless. You tend to be silent in respect and love. Even when you speak, you whisper. It is something I'll never forget. Seeing pictures and videos don't match being there. Thanks to all of you for the ultimate sacrifice.
A nation reveals itself not only by the men it produces, but also by the men it honors, the men it remembers.
Over 1 million free tickets have been distributed by the Veterans Tickets Foundation. their mission statement, supporting veterans and active duty military with entertainment, lasting memories, and reintegration opportunities by providing free tickets to sporting events, concerts, and family activities. I urge all of you to join Veterans Ticket Foundation. There is no charge, no obligation. We are lucky to have people who work so tirelessly to keep our veterans in people's memory.
God.